So as you saw, I have lots of filaments, and I am sure lots of other people have lots of filament as well. So what I have done is make a site to actually have the ability to have to keep inventory of all your filaments, not just draws, also samples and other things. So what I are going to do is I'm going to walk briefly through the site. We are going to add some new filaments to my inventory. I already have a bunch, and I'm going to show you some of the other features. So the whole goal of Filament Juno is to actually provide a simple way to keep inventory of your filament. We are going to have, and we already have some of them, manufacturers and default filaments added to our site, and you can add more. And by doing so, you are be able to add new filaments very easy to your inventory. Okay, so let's switch to the site and we are going to see how everything looks. So what we have here is the index page of Filament Juno. And I'm currently logged in, so I see a bit more issues, so please keep that in mind. So the very first thing is, let's see what I already have in my inventory, because I already did add some inventory because I have a lot of them and I don't want to add all of them into this video. So the first thing is, let's open my inventory here. And we see here two rows of wood fill, for example. The first row is actually empty. The filament left is 0 grams. It was a spool of 1800 grams, and the total weight of the spool when I got it was 200 or 2.4 kilograms. The second row here is this one, and I printed some of that. It was again a 1.8 kilogram spool, and there is around 1.2 kilograms left. So I did print around 600 grams. Now, as you can see, I have lots more filaments here. Different types. For example, here we have my PLA spools, and you can navigate to the next page for PLA. And as you can see, I have lots of them from different different manufacturers, different colors and things like that. I also have some Engen Lux, some Tolman T-Glass, some Colorfab PLA PHA, some special filament, in this case Colorfab Cork Fill, some PETG, some PVA, some normal Engen, some HCPLA from Protopasta. So as you can see, I already have a lot of filament added to my inventory. For example, when I want to print with this filament, I just click here, I fill in how much I printed here, and then it is subtracted from what I printed. Well, I didn't print with it, so I'm not going to do that. If I want to mark it empty because the spool is empty, or then I just press mark empty, and then it just marks it as 0 filament left. So what we also have is a public profile, and this is a setting. It is not required to actually enable this, but you can. If you don't enable it, then it won't be public, so it will only be visible to you for yourself. So here it has some information on what I have in my inventory. So in total I have 40 rows. In my case it are rows. I didn't add any samples yet, but you can also add samples, and we will come to that in a minute. Of those 40 rows, 20 are actually full, so I have a bunch of full rows, and one is empty. I printed 8.6 kilograms from it. Of course, I did print a lot more in the last few years, but because I just started it, it is just from the spools that are half full or something like that. There's also some filament flavors, and I have mostly PLA. Around of those 40 are 22 PLAs, and the rest is something else. I do have some 3mm filament because I have the Ultimaker 3, and that uses 3mm filament, so that's here as well. And in total I have 21.8 kilograms of filament in stock that is right now here written down. So we make some nice graphs here, sir. These are updated at the moment when you add some new filament or you print something. So it has been a while since I printed, so the last statistics are here from April 12th. But if we are going to add some new filament in a moment, then we will see that this graph is updated. And you can see the total rate here is the blue line and the black line is what I printed. And this is the total pieces statistics with one row empty and in total 40 rows. So what we have more is a list of manufacturers. So this is something that right now I've added myself mostly, but in the future the goal is to have everyone being able to add a new manufacturer and a new type of filament. That way everyone can really easy add new rolls of filament to his profile. So for example, I have here a roll of Matter Hackers pink PLA. I didn't submit that yet to my inventory, so let's see if Matter Hackers are already here. They are. So let's see if PLA is already in the list. So how can we add this to the inventory? That's really simple, simply by pressing the button over here, add to inventory. So let's do that. And in this case, I did already print with this filament. It is opened, so I did put it on a scale and there was 1200 grams exactly left. Because when I created this entry, I knew already that the full weight of the spool was 1275 grams. So what I can do now is subtract the 1200 grams is left now from this spool and from that 1275, and know that there is 75 grams printed with this already. So what I do, I fill in here filament already used, and that is 75. We also need to fill in the color, and this is pink, so we filled it in. And currently that is just a freeform text, so you can fill in exactly what you want yourself. And I'm still considering changing that, but we will see what others think about that. That's another thing. Please let me know if you have any feature suggestions, bugs or anything. Just let me know and we will try to get that updated and get it fixed. So that is everything, and we just press submit and it is raw added to your inventory, and it will probably be here at the we have Matter Hackers that wasn't it. So I'm still looking on finding a better way to actually sort this, because as you can see, it's probably a bit hard to find it. So here it is. It is the Matter Hackers PLA. It's pink and we have 925 grams left. So now if we are going to my public profile, you see there is one row more. And you can see the graph is nicely updated. So I didn't do a lot here, and then I added here to one row. That's the very first method to add a new row. Another method is actually adding it from your inventory yourself. You can choose here for two buttons, and in this case again I'm going to add a row from manufacturer. And in this case I have a row of blue PLA from Eason. So what I'm going to do is choose for Eason. That's already added as well. It is Eason PLA. So let's edit. It is a blue color, and again I did put this row on a scale and there was 1 kilo exactly left over. So this spool was 1260 grams when it was new, so there is 260 grams printed already. And we can add this to the inventory, and it is there again. We go to the next page to check it is for sure there. Yes, there it is. It is the Eason PLA Blue. And there's 740 grams left for this raw. So by having already default provided filament types, it is really easy to add new filaments. And by filling in the form as complete as possible, other users will be able to use that and add new rows really easy. So let me check the public profile. It is again 42 grams. And you can see the graphs are nicely updated. I'm currently also looking into suggestions for how to improve or how to add mirror statistics here, because I think with the numbers we have, you can add lots more statistics. So if you have any suggestions again, please let me know. Another thing we are going to do is I got the Profibox Mini, which I won a few weeks ago. So let's add these samples as well to my inventory, because, well, we just added mostly rolls. Because you are able to fill in all weights yourself, you can also add just samples. Okay, so let's go to the manufacturer's page to check if we already have the filament one manufacturer within our system. So let's go to manufacturers here and let's check. We have filament PM, that's not. We have filamentum, so we don't have filament one. So the first thing we are going to do is fill in this form here. The very first thing we need to fill in is the actual name of the manufacturer, so that is a filament one. I already copied the URL and I'm just going to add their logo, and I just downloaded it from their site and used that. So let's submit that. And it says new manufacturer submitted successfully. And I will receive an email that it is approved, but what I'm going to do is check our admin page and approve it from there. So let's open that. And this is not something you will be able to do, but this makes it a bit easier for this video. So let's just here approve it. And it should be able to move over, and it is now published, as you can see here. So if we now check the site, it's here, filament one. So what we can do now, when well at our all samples, we can still add them as filament. The only thing we don't know is the filament weight, so we won't be able to fill that in, unfortunately. But we are still being able to provide some basic information about the filaments. So let's start filling it in. And in this box there was some PLA Pro, some PETG Pro, and some PLA Plus Pro. So we are going to fill all of those in the system. And we just use some default information about the filaments. Okay, so let's start with the filament one PLA Pro Select. So what I have done is I checked their site to see what filament size they're selling. And they are only selling in kilograms. So we are able to provide that as basic information already. So let's start. This is PLA Pro Select. The total weight in grams we don't know, so we can't fill that in, but we know it is a kilogram. So let's submit that. That's the first one. And again, these need to be approved afterwards, so we won't see them yet, but we will approve them in a minute and add them later. We have again this one. So, and the next one is PETG Pro Select, so let's add that one as well. PETG Pro Select, and this is again 1000 grams, and this is PETG, so we choose for PETG over here, and we add that to the list. And the last one is a PLA Plus Pro Select, so PLA Plus Pro Select. It is 1000 grams and it is PLA, so we add it. So now let's switch over to the admin interface again. And we have three new rows added. So we approve this one and this one. And I will now have a lot of emails that a new filament is added. And as you can see here, we have the filaments. So the next thing to do again is add this to the inventory. So the first thing we do need to know is how much filament are these samples actually. So what I've done is I looked up the Profibox Mini, which these samples are from, and it says it is 55 grams. So what we are going to do is we are going to start with PLA Pro. We are going to add that to the inventory. Because this is a sample, we are going to choose here for sample. And this is just optional. It just makes the statistics a bit nicer. It doesn't have any functionality that you choose sample here. So it is green silk. It is 1.75. The total weight in grams is 55. And the total weight is 55. And what I do is add a notification or a note for myself that I know where this is from. So I know, and I now just hit submit, and I got an error. Ah, yes. I don't need to. So you better, because this is not a spool and I filled in the same information for both, it doesn't allow that because, yeah, that's not possible. So you should just leave the total weight in grams empty. And if something is wrong with your submission, it just gives you an error to tell you what you need to fix. So this should be fixed now. And there we go. And if we go to the last page for PLA, you can check if it is there. And there it is, filament 1 PLA Pro Select. So perfectly. So, and you can see the notification is here, the filament weight is here, and we added it right now. So we are going to do the next, and the next one is the red one, and that is also a Pro Select. So we do it from here, and we choose filament 1, and we choose the Pro Select again. We basically do the same thing. Sample, the color is red. It is 55 grams. And we add the note. And we are going to do the next. This is a PETG Pro. And as you can see, because we already filled in all information before, it is really easy to add more and more information to your inventory. So that is the whole goal of filament, you know, making filament inventory easy. And then we need to add the last one, the filament 1 PLA Plus. So we choose again filament 1. We choose for PLA Pro. And this is called light gray. And it is again a sample. It is 55 grams. And we add it. Now, if we go to our public profile, you can see we have 42 rolls and we have 4 samples. So basically, the if you choose rolls or samples, only give some nice statistics, and that's all. There is no real information about if you use rolls or samples. Everything else is just completely the same. And as you can see, we also have some statistics. It is nice going up. The amount of pieces is going up. So that's really nice. So the last way to add a new type of inventory is actually just use add more filament. And from there, you get basically the same form as you get when asked from manufacturer. The only thing is now you need to provide the manufacturer name and all information yourself. This also won't add this manufacturer to the public listing. So it only will be available for yourself. So in a lot of cases, you might want to do this, but probably not. If you want to help others, also keeping inventory, you probably should not use this form. But it is still there to help you. So that's basically it. This is the Filament Juno site. I made it to make keeping inventory for filament really easy. As you can see, we added the few filaments I have within minutes to our inventory, and you get some nice statistics on how, and you get some nice statistics on your filament stock and things like that. If you have any suggestions, please leave them in the comments below or on GitHub. I will place a link in the video description. The version you see online right now will be changing in the upcoming weeks. There are still some things I would like to change, for example how the inventory is shown, because it's sometimes really hard if you have more filaments in your inventory to see what you have. But if you have any suggestions on how to make it better, please let me know in the comments or at GitHub, and I will do my best to reply and implement them on the site. The site will be free, so you just need to register. And that's it. There is no other requirement to do. I will need your email address to send you some information and to activate your account. But that's all. There is an option to make your profile public, but that's not required at all. It does add something to it, so you can show it to others. But that's it. So if you have any questions, please let me know. And I hope you are going to use it. And thanks for watching. And bye for now.